Hello friends, welcome to Spice Dhamal. I am in the beautiful historic city of Aurangabad and welcome to the channel. I had told you in my earlier blog that I will be traveling to Aurangabad and to find some unique eats. So I am your host Nitin and this is a beautiful setting of Vivanta Aurangabad by the Taj Group. And on our food journey of Aurangabad, today we got a very unique dish. It has a history and it has a journey. There are very few dishes in the country similar to biryani which has a history and a journey like this. And this dish is only available in this city. It is not made anywhere else. The dish is named as Naan Khaliya. So naan is a specific type of bread and khaliya or a kalia is the spicy curry which is made from meats. So different types of meats are used for this particular preparation. But the speciality is this dish is made in a Muslim wedding in Aurangabad. So if you don't make a good khaliya and serve to the guest in the wedding, they will be very upset. That's what locals say here. So over the years, the chefs who used to prepare it for weddings, they started opening small restaurants. So we could not go to that kind of a restaurant and test, but what we have done is we have sent our cameras and they have taken a nice video how it is made in the restaurant. And I'm going to taste it for you. Naan bread, and it is distinctly different from what we eat in a restaurant. The recipe is also different. So this bread, it is yellow in color, and what gives this yellow shine is not kesar like shirmal, it is actually turmeric, and it is served with this oily spicy curry which is called as khaliya. So the history of this dish is when the Mughal Sultan ordered his capital to be Daulatabad or the today's Aurangabad. That time the forces or his armies which were ruling this area, they were from northern India and they wanted to create a dish which will give a nourishment, vitality, and the dish can be kept fresh for couple of days. So that was the time this type of a naan was made by their chefs. Unlike most of the recipes in Mughal cuisine which were made for Nawabs, this was a dish which was made for the soldiers and the common people, so that this food has to be nice and rustic. Once you eat it, it has to give you energy for 8 to 10 hours. So this naan is made with mixture of flour. So there is some refined flour, there is some wheat which goes into it, and it is the yeast, the local yeast or khamir that is added to it. And once the bread is proofed, it is baked in a special type of furnace. But before baking, they put a layer of turmeric water. Now turmeric act as a two advantages. First advantage is, due to turmeric, there is less chance of bread getting spoiled as it's an antiseptic. Second thing is, when you consume turmeric, the soldiers who are not used to the monsoons of Maharashtra, 4 month long monsoons of Maharashtra, they used to get boost of immunity due to turmeric in their food. So that was a dual purpose. And this naan, as soon as it goes into oven, it pops up like a half balloon, and then it is kept good for 1 to 2 days. Now let us come to this khaliya or the curry. Now this khaliya, it's made from meat, poppy seed paste, coconut paste and some spices, and it's cooked in a deeg for a couple of hours so that all the flavors are absorbed by the curry, and there is a good amount of oil. So that becomes a nourishing meal on a winter day or any day. And now we will taste and see how it is. But to taste it, you need to eat it the Aurangabad style. You need to make small pieces of your naan bread and add it to your kalia. And look, the bread is very soft and it has a unique taste and texture. Now, once the bread gets nicely soaked up in that curry, then you taste it. Spicy, but very flavorful. There are very few dishes which gives you that kind of a mouthfeel. This is one of them. And you have a good portion of this, and then 8-10 hours you don't have to eat anything. So this was a very unique naan khaliya for you from Aurangabad. Let us see what all we find in this city. So friends, another place very special in Aurangabad which was recommended by everybody was to try the tea by Barkat Tea House. It's a very small place but always busy, bustling, and their speciality is they reduce the milk for a couple of hours to make this tea nice, sweet and creamy. So I tasted it today morning and it was absolutely tasty and worth for 10 rupees. Delicious, sweet and tasty tea. So let me show you the Barkat Tea House in Aurangabad. Whenever you are in Aurangabad, it's a historic city, there is a lot of sightseeing. So, and if you go to Ajanta, the full day is taken, whenever you go out to Werur or Daulatabad Fort, there is a lot of time you are walking and generally you are tired, so you tend to eat at the hotels you stay. But we still managed to go out for you and find out which are different good restaurants. Now, one of the good yardstick in any city to find out about restaurant, a restaurant which has maximum number of Google reviews. So we went to 4-5 places which had maximum number of Google reviews and we found them absolutely delicious also, but we did not do a full long tasting video there, but we have taken a couple of pictures, so that I am going to share with you in a video. But another dish I would like to mention here, it is there in all the restaurants, which is called Kentucky Chicken. Now basically this is a spicy Aurangabadi version of Kentucky Fried Chicken. Nice red color, crispy coating, so that was absolutely delicious. And in general in Aurangabad you will see, due to its Mughal influences, you have a lot of Mughlai cuisine or the non-veg restaurants, and all of them do delicious North Indian style, Mughlai style food. So that was a good change and a good taste. With this, we are ending our Aurangabad food vlog. However, if you need more details about any of the restaurants we visited, so in description I will be giving their names. But if you need any further details, do comment. Do let me know if you feel any other places are much better in the comment box. So I'll be happy to see those comments as well. And so this is a new section for channel Spice Dhamal. If you like the video, make sure you like it, subscribe it, and press the bell icon so that whenever we put any new video, that then you get an instant notification. Until we meet again in a new vlog, stay happy, stay healthy, enjoy cooking, and keep eating.